Welcome viewers. This is what it feels like to drive the top of the line AMG from Mercedes-Benz. We are Satya and Gargi, and we bring to you the experience of driving the S63 AMG. It is here where civility meets brutality.
Luxury and performance are contradictory. It's hard to say what sounds better, this 23-point Burmester sound system or this extraordinary engine. It's both Bruce Banner and the Incredible Hulk. Serene and savage, restrained and raucous, technologically apt and primitive in its ferocity. The coupe is uncompromising. This luxurious car can't hide its motorsport roots. They're in its genes. And you can feel them both when you hop in and bring the 4-liter biturbo to life. Oh, when the 612 horses gallop, all they want you is to smile. And smile you do as it races you from a 0 to 100 in a mere 3.5 seconds. This combination of pure force that combines with pure emotion is what makes this car the perfect performance machine. They say it's been designed to surpass even the highest expectations, and they're not lying. Welcome to the world of the special Mercedes. This is impeccably styled inside and out. Words can hardly describe what this looks like. It's so remarkable that it's hard to believe it's true. It starts from these emphatic power drums, this unique grille, leading to the lines on the bonnet that go miles long. The elegance on the roofline and these frameless windows are just the appetizers on a 7-course meal that fills you up with performance and poise. It's a sight to behold from any angle. And this attention to detail is extraordinary. The finish on the inside is outstanding. It's so comfortable, it brims with luxury. The feel of the leather is so special, and the stitching on the seats just makes it so beautiful. In fact, this coupe is so pretty, we thought we should take a real photographer and take some wonderful pictures and show you how pretty this really is.
Hey!
Isn't she hot?
She's talking about the car.
Come, let's take him for a ride. Where do you want to go?
Okay, just tell me one thing. What Mercedes is this?
It's a very special Mercedes. It is called the S63 AMG Coupe. It is the most exclusive of its kind, you know. It is sensational, amazing, and it is thrilling.
No one wants to forgo luxury, not even at the speeds of 300. It's true luxury on wheels. It's like owning a private jet. You arrive fast and in style.
This fine Mercedes redefines the idea of a supercar. Tell me, what is the point of having a car which costs you few bags of money? It drives fast, it's amazing to look at, but it is not comfortable. This is how a supercar should be. It's thrilling because it drives fast, it's sensational to look at, and it's pure driving pleasure.
So simply put, if you're able to afford this, the chances are you're 50 years old. And at that age, you need comfortable seats and the ones that massage you. You need all the luxuries like heated seats, heated armrests, because you worked really hard to deserve this.
And when you want to go fast, this V8 with two turbos produces magic which takes you places. The power this AMG packs for you is like nothing else. Makes you scream with joy.
It's like power of 6 regular cars put together. And for days when you're driving to work because you're still not retired yet and you have to be all decent and dignified like how a top boss of the company should be, this engine management system lets you be just that.
The system turns off 4 of the 8 cylinders of this AMG and turns into a fuel-saving, distinguished 4-cylinder, polarized-friendly car. It's all silent and cocooned in luxury.
Okay, hang on. What is this AMG?
Established in 1967, the company at Affalterbach employs 1,300 people who work together to develop fascinating performance vehicles and sports cars.
AMG stands for Aufrecht Melker Groschenspark, which comes from the names of its two founders, Hans Werner Aufrecht and Erhard Melcher. And G is for Aufrecht's birthplace, Groschenspark. Affalterbach is the headquarters of Mercedes AMG, and this ultra-high-tech facility employs a one-man, one-engine policy, which means even this engine was hand-built by just one person. He's responsible for it, and he gets to sign it. Another serious luxury of this car is the driving assistance. It'll now follow the car in front and also steer a little, so that even such traffic situations are less stress. The front logo is a radar and it helps computers calculate everything and keeps us within lanes and at safe distance from the car in the front. It even brakes for you, accelerates, and it's one step closer to autonomous driving. Only 20% of the road traffic is at night, but 40% of the fatal accidents occur during this period. The Night View Assist Plus helps you find such idiots on the road easily. They are clearly highlighted in the cockpit display. It's a technological masterpiece by Mercedes. A thermal imaging camera on the front grille is able to give a precise warning by identifying the relevant objects from the ones that are not. When it comes to animals and pedestrians, the system flashes them automatically to warn them of an approaching car. It's just so cool, you know. It makes driving it so much more a pleasure.
This new 8-cylinder is a sweetheart. Its bark is equal to its bite. It packs 612 horses and eagerly revs to a 7,000 RPM redline.
The combination of two turbochargers with variable exhaust systems baritone produces a sweet symphony.
It proclaims the potency of S63 with every tap of the accelerator.
Switch the exhaust from comfort mode to sport plus and you will unleash an even more ferocious crescendo that bangs and crackles like devil's popcorn.
We traveled for almost 400 kilometers with a full night of a drive, but I feel fresher than when we started. I don't think there are any other cars which can do that.
It's a Mercedes, and it's synonymous to luxury, comfort, and performance. The S63's cabin pampers all within it, the ones at the back and the front. The 12-way adjustable front seats with the heating and cooling functions, a surround view camera, automatic high beam headlights, lane departure warning, blind spot assist, and a navigation system are all a standard. The latest command infotainment system that consists of two 12.3-inch screens forms this wonderful piece of glass on the dash. One screen is positioned behind the steering wheel and combines the digital gauge cluster with the infotainment functions. The other sits in the middle of the dash and is meant purely for entertainment. Both screens are controlled by capacitive switches located on the flat bottom steering wheel. The command center and the touchpad also help you navigate menus. The rear seat passengers are appropriately pampered as well. The lack of the B-pillar makes way for an outstanding view, and the beveled logo studded center console offers plenty of storage. The large door openings make it easy for passengers to get in and get out of the cozy back seat. In fact, the combination of raw power and the co-sitting controls makes it for a surprisingly engrossing driving experience when barreling down back roads at breakneck pace. The 9-speed automatic transmission responds quickly to the meaty paddle shifters. And in short, even when this is a 16-foot-long car, it's no difficult to drive and maneuver than a video game. Tackling tight two-lane roads in the S63 Coupe is a lot like carving butter with a chainsaw. It might be the wrong tool for the job, but it sure is fun to slice it with.
It really is a lifestyle, this car. It's not made for the customary. It's special and made for the extraordinary.
In fact, this car is so special. It's like a chariot for the kings and queens of speed. It's for the celebrities, the distinguished and the eminent.
It's really a fantastic car. But I just want to ask you one thing. Why do you keep on saying that it's very special?
Did you not see the grill? That is what makes it so special. Let me tell you about it.
The Carrera Pan Americana. A road race of more than 3,000 kilometers over 5 days through Mexico. In 1952, a German team competes for the first time and wins a double victory. The car, the Mercedes-Benz 300 SL. The S63 AMG's grille is a tribute to a legendary car in Mercedes-Benz's history. The 300 SL. The first of the SLs was an out-and-out racing car, and it also won Le Mans the same year. For the Carrera Panamericana race, held across the Pan-American Highway in Mexico, Mercedes-Benz brought its drivers, three cars, trucks filled with parts and mechanics directly from Germany to tackle the race. The story goes that exiting out of a flat-out right-hand curve, the Mercedes collided with a vulture at some 120 miles an hour. The bird broke through the windshield on Klenk's side and knocked him unconscious. In spite of his facial injuries and his bleeding, Klenk quickly regained his composure and told Kling to keep the pedal down. The two drove for a further 43 miles before they could stop for a tire change. Only then did Klenk receive some medical attention, and the mechanics mounted 8 vertical bars in place of the windshield to protect the driver and co-driver from other unforeseen hazards. Karl Kling and Hans Klenk won the race in the sports car category in spite of a bloody incident that took place during the first stage.
All's well, but still, is it special enough to buy it?
There are just 3 more reasons to buy this car. One, this is just the car made for a driver. And if you are young, let's say you're 50 and you're young at heart, this is the best thing money can buy for you.
Cars like these are just epic. Words fail the motion when we talk about cars like these. Mercedes-Benz made the first automobile with the gasoline engine. It was way back in 1881, and it was called the 1901 Mercedes. Count it, and it was 139 years ago. 139 years they've been making it better and better and better. It's been a relentless pursuit. The S63 AMG here today is one of the most powerful engines that Mercedes has ever made. So it's the most technologically advanced. In a way, this 139 years of research from the mainstream manufacturer is all put into this engine right here. And you know what? The next generation of this car is going to be a remote controlled car. It's going to have batteries. Yes, it's going to look as good, and it's going to go as fast as this, and also as powerful as this one. But you're going to miss the sound, the smell of gasoline, and the vibration. We don't always want this instantaneous acceleration, an analog response of the throttle as the petrol goes in and ignites, explodes in those cylinders and delivers power. That's probably the sweetest delay ever. This crackle of the exhaust when you shift down and the jerk it gives, the happiness you feel when you make that perfect gear shift will all be missed. A few years later, when you open the bonnet of your car, most likely you'll find a place to keep your purse. But there won't be an engine. The joy of looking at an engine that's neatly stuffed and the pleasure of gazing at the source of all this power would be missed. This engine might just be the last one Mercedes makes, and no car after may have something like this. It's the epitome of sweat, toil, and research of all those who worked on Mercedes engines for the past 139 years. This is a pure car. And sometimes cars are special because how they make us feel. This one makes you feel special when you sit in it, when you drive it. It feels special even when you look at it. And as you get out, the attention it gets you makes you feel special even when you're not in it. This is a wonder on the road. If you have the money, just go ahead and buy this. If not, don't buy stupid stuff. Save and buy this. Because someone's rightly said, this surely is the best or nothing.
दोस्तों, आप ऐसा बिल्कुल भी मत सोचना कि ऐसे वीडियोस हम सिर्फ इंग्लिश में बनाएंगे। जल्द ही हम आपके लिए इसी फिल्म का हिंदी वीडियो लेकर आ रहे हैं।